In this video, we'll explore how to apply repository patterns in .NET Core. I'll be demonstrating the implementation with a Blazor web app, although the same approach can be applied to any .NET Core applications. Here, I have created two entities. The initial entity pertains to product categories and contains some properties. This collection of products property facilitates foreign key mapping. The second entity is the product, which includes properties such as name, price, and product category ID mapping. Next, we'll proceed to develop repository classes for these entities. It's important to note that you can incorporate as many entities as necessary for your project. The source code for this project is available on my Patreon page. Join my Patreon to access exclusive benefits. Moving forward, we'll establish a folder named repositories. Subsequently, we'll generate a new interface called iProductCategoryRepository with this designated folder. Adopting the practice of implementing services with interfaces is considered a best practice. This approach encourages loose coupling, facilitating seamless replacement or extension of implementations without disrupting the overall functionality of the application. In this interface, we'll outline the necessary methods for the product category repository. The initial method will retrieve all the product categories and will be named get. The subsequent method is designated for fetching a product category based on its unique identifier. Following that, we'll define a method for creating a new product category. Subsequently, another method will be implemented for updating existing product categories. Lastly, we'll include a method specifically for deleting product categories. We'll proceed by creating a class called ProductCategoryRepository within the same folder. Initially, we'll inherit the class from the previously defined interface. Implementing the interface will automatically include the required methods in the class. Before starting the method implementation, we'll declare a private read-only object of the DB context and assign it within the class constructor. In the create method, we utilize the addAsync method to save the product category. Additionally, we ensure changes are persisted using the saveChangesAsync method. For the delete method, we remove the designated product category and subsequently save the changes. The get method retrieves all the product categories and returns them as a list. To fetch a product category by its unique identifier, we filter based on the ID and returns the result. It's important to note that this method's return type should be nullable to accommodate situations where no record matches the provided ID, both here and in the interface. Finally, in the update method, we implement the necessary steps to modify the product category and ensure changes are saved thereafter. With these implementations, the product category repository is now fully operational. Moving on to the product repository, we'll begin by establishing the interface named iProductRepository. If you are curious about how interfaces facilitate easy replacement of implementations, you can refer to our video on .NET Core Dependency Injection, where I have demonstrated this specific topic. Similar to the product category repository interface, here I will also define the following methods. Firstly, a get method for retrieving all the products. Secondly, another get method for fetching a product by its unique identifier. Following that, methods for create, update, and delete operations will be defined. We'll proceed by creating the product repository class. This class will inherit from the newly created interface, and we'll proceed to implement its methods. Before diving into the method implementations, we'll acquire the DB context service in the constructor and assign it to a private read-only object. Let's begin by implementing the create method to add the product and save the changes. Next, we'll implement the delete method to remove the product and save changes accordingly. In the get method, we'll retrieve all the products and return them as a list. In this get method, we'll include a filtering mechanism based on the product ID to return the corresponding product object. Lastly, we'll implement the update method to modify the product details and ensure changes are saved. With these implementations, both repositories are now complete. Let's proceed with dependency injection in the program.cs class. Initially, we'll add the product category repository as a scoped service. Following the same approach, we'll also add the product repository. With these services configured, we can now implement the CRUD functionalities in our application. I won't delve into the design aspects and Blazor components in detail in this video. You can explore more about Blazor in our Blazor tutorial series. The playlist link is available in the description. So I have done the implementation and let me show you the product category page. As you can observe, I have injected the product category repository interface. In the code section, you'll notice that I have utilized the get, create, update, and delete methods of our product category repository. Now, moving on to the product page, where I have injected both product category repository and product repository interfaces. Since I'm displaying the product category selection option here, the product category repository interface is also required. I'll demonstrate it shortly. In the code section, we are making use of the get, create, update, and delete methods of the product repository. Let's execute the project and observe how the application functions. In the product category page, we'll attempt to add a new category. Category successfully added. Let's add one more. Now, let's try editing the description of the first category. I'll provide some description and the update is successful. Next, I'll attempt to delete the category. The deletion process is also functioning as expected. Let's add one more category to ensure we have enough to display in the product's page. Let me change the name of category 3 to category 4. Now, in the product page, you'll notice the categories we added available in the select options. Let's attempt to add a new product. The product is saved successfully. Now, let's try adding one more. Next, we'll attempt to edit the product. The changes are successfully saved. I'll proceed to delete this product, and we can see all the functionalities are working as expected. Don't forget to visit our Patreon page, where you can access the source code and enjoy exclusive benefits. I hope the concept of repository pattern is now clear to you. If you found this video helpful, please consider liking, sharing, and subscribing to our channel. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Happy coding!